she gave up trying to use the phone on the wall and just used her cell phone.
Objection! I have to conclude that you have a personal grudge against Ms. Lana Skye. Objection! The witness is a former detective. Her testimony is unmarred by personal bias.
Well, who would have thought you would be my knight in shining armor, prosecutor? You, who, together with the chief prosecutor, kicked me out 2 years ago.
Well, Ms. Starr, this is a fatal contradiction with your testimony. How do you explain this?
I don't know what you're talking about. Mess with me, and I'll make you cough it all up.
Let's look at the floor plans. You said you witnessed the crime from this point. However, if that's true, you couldn't possibly have seen Ms. Skye making that phone call. I believe you see what I'm getting at. That emergency phone was on the back side of this partition. If, indeed, you were in B Block, you couldn't have seen it.
What?
Order! Order! What is the meaning of this?
It's simple, Your Honor. She's not coughing up lunch. She's coughing up lies. Objection!
That's quite a claim, Mr. Wright. Perhaps you will allow me a question. Tell us exactly what lie this witness has told the court.
Here's where the counterattack begins. I can't afford to get this wrong. The witness lied about... She tried to use the emergency phone, but it was out of order. What is significant about this fact? Nothing. It would be pointless for her to lie about it.
Pointless to lie. I see.
The witness did actually see Ms. Skye using the emergency phone. In other words, Ms. Starr witnessed the crime from a different location. Objection!
A different location? Now that's a pointless lie if I ever heard one.
Objection! Before you call my lie pointless, at least let me tell it.
Let me ask a question to our clever wordsmith, Mr. Wright. Just where was the witness when she saw the crime?
All the testimony we've heard until now points in one direction. The place from where Ms. Starr witnessed this crime was... here. Take that! This is the only place where she could have been.
The security guard room?
Indeed. The security room in the underground parking lot is well positioned. It's built on the second level, so you can see the entire lot.
She would have been able to see the emergency phone from there. But why there? There are many other places where she could have seen the phone.
Not in this case, Your Honor. The witness, not being a part of the prosecutor's office, couldn't park in A Block. The only place where she could have seen the crime and the back of the partition is here. I remember in your testimony, you said you brought a lunch to your boyfriend in the security guard room, yes? Well, Ms. Starr?
How many years have I been getting the better of men? To think that the tables could be turned. Today, a man has got the better of Angel Starr.
Order! Order, witness! What have you done? You used to be a detective. You should know better.
Well, I'm not turning back. The guilty will be punished. And I'll do what I must to make sure justice prevails.
The guilty? Is she talking about Ms. Skye?
Mr. Wright, doesn't it strike you as odd? Why did Miss Starr lie? It doesn't make sense.
Huh?
She could have just said she saw the crime from the security guard station. It wouldn't change anything.
Exactly. This photograph tells all. It was the defendant who stabbed the victim. That truth still stands. Objection! It still stands. I disagree, Mr. Edgeworth. What? If a witness is found to be lying, they're guilty of perjury. She knows this. She wouldn't risk that without a good reason.
So, tell us what her reason was, Mr. Wright.
Huh? Me?
Who else?
Mr. Wright, let's review what we know.
Ms. Starr witnessed the crime from the security guard station. But she lied and said she saw it from B Block. It must make a vital difference. But what? What would change? It changes the distance between her and the scene of the crime. Objection!
My condolences, Mr. Wright. But one look at the floor plans and it's quite clear. The distance between the scene of the crime and the guard station is 30 feet. I don't see how that would change what she could see.
Objection! What she saw is not in question here. What matters is the time it would take her to reach the scene of the crime. Ms. Starr, you witnessed the crime from the security guard station. Now, how long did it take you to go from there to the scene of the crime where you arrested Ms. Sky?
Well, witness?
You...
Yes?
You ordered the squid wheels, right?
The quality of my lunches has gone from low to inedible.